Welcome back, everybody, to Joe Russo Field. My name is Jordan Leonard, and we are in for a treat tonight as the 6-1 Palm Beach Diamond Ducks play host to the 2-3 Phipps Park Barracudas. To start today's broadcast, let's take a check around the action from today's SFCBL. The Pompano Beach Clippers defeated the Boynton Beach Buccaneers 17-10. And the West Boca Snappers defeated the Delray Beach Lightning 4-0 earlier. And in action right now at Little Fenway, the West Palm Beach Knights lead the Boca Raton Blazers 2-0. On the mound for the Diamond Ducks to start this one is Robbie Troop. Troop in his first outing against the Extreme, 3 innings pitched, a strikeout and 2 hits. He gets the start today for the Diamond Ducks. And up first for the Barracudas, Kyle Platt out of Salve Regina University. He takes the fastball inside for strike number one to get things started off. Platt in 3 games, 1-for-6 with a walk and a hit by pitch. His 0-1 fastball fouled off to the right side. Quickly 0-2 to the leadoff hitter and the second baseman today. Troop into the windup. His 0-2 swung on and missed for strike three, and we have our first strikeout of the day to the first batter of the day for Robbie Troop. Now up for the Barracudas, Tanner Sweat, with one out here in the top of the first. Troop into the windup. His fastball is inside for ball number one. Let's align you with the Diamond Ducks defense. Sean Williams behind the plate today. Cole Vida back at first base. Dalton Frank at second. As Troop's 0-1 fastball hits the inside corner. 1-1 now the count to the center fielder. Dom Presto after the day off back at shortstop. Joey Urban moves from short to third today. Padilla back in left. And the 1-1 fastball sits high. 2-1 the count. DJ Christian back in center field for the second straight day, and Jack Q back in right as well. Two-one fastball from Troop in there on the outer half at brings the count to 2-2 with one out here in the top of the first. Two-two off speed in the dirt brings the count full 3-2. To Tanner Sweat through 2 games out of Fayetteville Tech. 2 games so far in the summer season. 1-for-6, a run scored, an RBI, and 2 walks. Looking to draw another one here or get a hit. But he swings and misses for our second strikeout out of the first 2 batters. 2 straight strikeouts for Troop to begin the game, both swinging. Now up Kyle Machado. Kyle Machado out of Florida Gulf Coast. Batting third tonight. Troop's first pitch curveball to Machado in there at the knees for strike number one. Fastball on the lower half, fouled off, quickly 0-2 to the third baseman. Troop's 0-2 goes to the submarine, just misses low. 1-2 now the count. Troop offers both a 3/4 arm slot and can drop down to that submarine action from time to time. His 1-2 back in the submarine, fastball up this time, fouled off. Count remains 1-2 to Machado. Troop's 1-2 once more. Fastball inside and hits him. So the Barracudas have a base runner here with 2 outs on the hit by pitch. And Chris Scholler coming to the plate. a junior out of St. Thomas University, batting 250 through four games with an RBI and two walks. His first pitch fastball fouled off out of play for strike number one. Barracudas threw five games, 256 team batting average. That's second in the league. Still looking for their first hit with the fourth cleanup hitter up as he takes a strike on the inner half for strike number two. So back-to-back fastballs to start off Scholler here. Now 0-2 the count. Troops 0-2. Fastball fought off by Scholler. Count remains 0-2 here with two outs in the top of the first. Troop comes set. And his 0-2 once more. Summerine fastball in the outer half. Swung on and missed. Troop gets three strikeouts in the top of the first. And we go to the bottom half of the inning with Dom Presto leading off for the Ducks. Welcome back here to the bottom of the first as Robbie Troop struck out the side in the top half of the inning. And now starting on the mound for the Phipps Park Barracudas, Nick Santo out of Sal Regina University. One game pitched so far, two innings in that game. One hit, two walks, two Ks, and got the save in that one as well. The sophomore right-hander faces Dom Presto, Brad Hart, and Joey Urban to lead things off in the bottom of the first. And the Ducks have been off to an interesting start on offense. They have been hit by 18 pitches in the first seven games. That leads the league. 34 walks. That accumulates to a .410 on base percentage, which also leads the league. But the Phipps Park Barracudas pitching staff has been successful as well. A .225 opponent's batting average. That's third in the league. So it'll be a good matchup here tonight at the Pond. Leading off for the Ducks, Dom Presto, fifth in the league in on-base percentage at .591. And as I mentioned, the Ducks have been magnets for the baseball this year. Leads the league with four hit-by-pitches. Presto takes the first pitch slider on the outer half for strike number one. Presto hitting .357 through six games. Got the day off yesterday, back in the lineup and at shortstop today. Slider on the inner half this time, swung on and missed. Quickly 0-2 to the shortstop. O-2 to Presto. Another slider sits low this time, brings the count to 1-2. And the 1-2 slider. Chuck swing, he did not go, brings the count back even at 2-2. Nice slider down and away, got Presto to check a swing. First base umpire said he did not go. We're back even at 2-2. And Santo's offering fastball down and away, just missed, brings the count full to the leadoff hitter Presto. Santos 3-2, just misses on the inside, goes back to the curveball on 3-2, and Presto adds to his on-base percentage and walks to lead off the bottom of the first, bringing up the extra hitter tonight, Brad Hart. Hart threw five games, 2-for-8, 3 RBIs, 3 walks, and 2 hit-by-pitches. He has a 500 on-base percentage as well and comes up with Presto on first base and nobody out. Santo's first pitch to Hart sits high for ball number one. Great at-bat by Presto, down 0-2 quickly, works it to a full count and works the leadoff walk. Now the 1-0 to Hart. Fastball hits the inside half, brings the count even to 1-1. Mix of fastballs and sliders here early for Nick Santo. He comes set at the belt. 1-1 slider hits the outside corner. 1-2 now the count to the Wingate University product. One 2 fastball on the outside half, fouled off to the right. That'll get out of play. Count resets at 1-2 to Brad Hart, hitting second today with Joey Urban on deck and Dom Presto on with the leadoff walk at first base. Santos 1-2, Presto's in motion, and Brad Hart fouls off the slider. Count remains 1-2, Presto is in motion there. Now we'll go back to first on the foul ball. Set the Barracuda's defense. Max Goldfein behind the plate. Chris Scholler at first base. Kyle Platt at second. Dylan McLaughlin at short. Kyle Machado at third. Santos 1-2 once more. Slider grounded up the middle. The second baseman Platt steps on second and gets the out at first. A 4-4-3 double play. And now there's 2 outs here in the bottom of the first. Brad Hart gets a little unlucky there as the second baseman Platt shifted into the hole. He fields it right at the bag, steps on the base, and throws on to Scholler at first. Now 2 outs in the bottom of the first for Joey Urban, the third baseman. Urban batting 286 through the first 5 games, takes college strength number 1, 5 RBIs, leads the team. The outfield, Dylan Edwards in left, Tanner Sweat in center, as Joey Urban takes a fastball, lifts it up to Tanner Sweat in center, and he puts it out for the final out of the first. Joe DeNorcia is also in right field, as we are 3-1, scoreless, 0-0, going to the top of the second. Welcome back here to the top of the second as Robbie Troop is back out on the mound after striking out the side in the first, comes up and now will face the 5-hitter to lead off for the Barracudas, Dylan Edwards. Playing left field today out of Lane Community College, through 2 games, 1-for-7, 2 runs, and 2 RBIs. He looks to get things started leading off here in the top of the second. Stroop's first pitch fastball to Edwards in there on the outside corner. Strike number one to the left fielder. Stroop goes submarine there on 0-1, and Edwards fouls it back, moves the count to 0-2. Ducks have also been successful on the mound so far this year. 3.17 team ERA, as of right now the lowest in the league. They also have the lowest walks and hits per innings pitched at 1.26, and second in opponent's batting average at .218. That's a .218 opponent's batting average, and that is lowered on Troop's fourth straight strikeout to start the game. Four strikeouts in the first five batters for Troop. Now up the designated hitter, Colton McCautry out of Lane Community College as well. He swings and misses at a first pitch fastball. 0-1 now the count to the designated hitter. Through four games, he's hot. .429 batting average and four walks as well. He's an on-base machine through the first four games. Fastball on the inner half, fouled off. Quickly 0-2 to McCautry. Troop's 0-2. Fastball grounded on to Frank at second. He'll field that, and he can't field it. Bounced up on him a little bit there, and McCautry will reach on the E4 with one out here in the second. So first ball put into play for the Barracudas. Now up the shortstop, Dylan McLaughlin, out of Lane College. Four games, he's 2-for-11 in RBI and a walk, looking to get a rally started here with one out in the top of the second. His first pitch slider sits outside for ball number one. Troop comes set at the belt. And his 1-0 submarine fastball misses on the inside half. 2-0 now the count to the shortstop, with McCautry at first, reaching on the error by Dalton Frank at second base. McCautry dances off first base. Troop picks him off. Now two outs now in the top of the second. McCautry dancing off first base, looking to time up Troop. He didn't go, so he stepped off, threw on to first. Vida applied the tag. Two outs now, 2-0 to Dylan McLaughlin in the top of the second. Troop back in the full windup. His 2-0 fastball is grounded over to Frank at second. He'll field this one, throw on to Vida at first. And we are through 1.5, still 0-0 as the Diamond Ducks come up in the bottom half of the inning. Welcome back here to the bottom of the second, everyone, at Joe Russo Field. Cool day today. Sun's in left field, but not as aggressive as it was earlier today. And leading off for the Ducks here in the bottom of the second, red-hot designated hitter Joey Cicini. Out of Regis University, through five games, he's batting .375. But it, really, the story is what he's done the last two games. In the last two games, he's 5-for-8, four RBIs, and two hit-by-pitches. He's on fire and looking to start things off for the Ducks in the bottom half of the second. Santo's first pitch to Cicini sits high for ball number one. One-oh fastball to Cicini, popped up on the infield. Platt calls it at second base, settles under it, and puts it away for the first out of the second. Now up, the right fielder through seven games. The right fielder Jack Q through seven games, .438 on base percentage. And that's because two hit by pitches and a walk. That's a theme for the Ducks, as I mentioned. Many hit by pitches. He takes a first pitch curveball in there for called strike number one. Nice job by Nick Santo to get that curve in there for a called strike. Goes 0-1 slider, and Q bounces it over to McLaughlin at short. His throw is high. That'll go to the fence. The catcher Goldfein goes and backs it up and throws, and just in there at second base is Jack Q for a single and an error, or just a two-base error ruled on the field. So goes back-to-back, Santo goes back-to-back off-speed pitches to start Q. Q bounced it over to McLaughlin at short. He fielded it. Throw was too high. Goldfein, the catcher, backed it up, but it went to the fence on the right foul line, and Q was able to make it to second base with one out. And now Cole Vita at the plate out of Point Park University. He takes the first pitch fastball in the inside half for ball number one, batting .273 through five games with an RBI and three walks. He's looking to add to that RBI total with Jack Q in scoring position with one out. Santa goes back to the fastball, but misses low and away this time. 2-0 now the count. Santa comes set. His 2-0 goes to the slider. That's in there for a called strike. 2-1 now the count to the first baseman. Q's dancing at second. He's not in motion. Vita takes the fastball and flies it into left field. Edwards comes on and makes the sliding catch. What a catch by Dylan Edwards, coming in, goes into the slide, secures it for the second out. Q will go back to second. Two outs now in the bottom of the second for Dalton Frank. Frank back at second base today. Not doing so well with the bat to start the year, batting .071, but he's getting on base at a .235 clip with two walks. He takes the first pitch slider and launches it into center field. Sweats under it, though, and he puts it away for out number three. We are through two, still scoreless here at Joe Russo Field. Welcome back to Joe Russo Field here for the top of the third. Robbie Troup back out on the mound. Four strikeouts through the first two innings as he faces 8-9-10 in the Cudas order here in the third. Up first for the Cudas, the catcher, Max Goldfein out of Rollins College. Through two games, 0-for-4, still looking for his first hit, but has a walk as well. Troop's first pitch to Goldfein misses outside for ball number one. Troop into the windup. His 0-1 fastball on the outer half fouled off to the right side. Brings the count even at 1-1 to the catcher. One submarine fastball launched into left field. As Presto goes back into left, he'll put it away for out number one. Fastball on the inside half, jammed Goldfein. He popped it into short left field. The shortstop Presto went out and made the catch for out number one. Now up the extra hitter today. Gabriel Rodriguez. First pitch fastball at the knees, swung on and missed. Strike number one. Rodriguez out of Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University through four games, 1-for-7 and a walk. His 0-1 submarine fastball swung on and missed for strike number two. Troop doing a nice job of mixing up the regular three-quarters arm slot and the submarine action to keep hitters off balance. Quickly up 0-2 on the extra hitter. Back to the submarine. That fastball is launched into left field. DJ Christian in left will come on and make the catch for out number two. So correction, DJ Christian is in left field today. Jack Q in center and Levi Padilla in right. Troop's first pitch fastball to Joe DeNorcia fouled off for strike number one. Troop working quickly back into the windup. His 0-1 fastball on the inner half fouled off. Quickly now 0-2 to the right fielder. O2 fastball just off the outside half. 1-2 now to DeNorcia. Troop tried to pick off the outer half there with the fastball. Just missed. He's back into the windup. And the 1-2 in on the hands. Popped foul and gets out of play. Count remains 1-2 here with two outs in the top of the third. One-two fastball in there for strike three. That's Troop's fifth strikeout on the day as we head to the bottom half of the third. Still tied 0-0. Welcome back, everybody, here for the bottom of the third. Leading off for the Ducks, the left fielder Levi Padilla. He got the day off yesterday. Back in the lineup today, five games played thus far this summer, batting .308 with three RBIs and two stolen bases. Playing right field today, usually in left, playing right field today. He's batting to lead off in the bottom of the third. Nick Santo back out on the mound and into the windup. His first pitch slider fouled off to the left side for strike number one. Santo's 0-1 fastball misses low, brings the count back even to 1-1 on Padilla. Padilla takes the 1-1 fastball inside, 2-1 now the count to the left fielder. Nobody out here in the bottom of the third. Still no hits for either team. One error apiece though, but no hits. 2-1 slider in the dirt, 3-1. Presto walked to lead off the first for the Ducks. Padilla looking to walk to lead off the third with the 3-1 count. Santo's fastball on the inner half for a called strike brings the count full to the left fielder Padilla. Santo into the windup, 3-2 slider fouled off. Count remains full here, leading off the bottom of the third. And the 3-2 once more, fastball just misses below the knees. Santo now two walks on the day, both to lead off an inning, one in the first, now one in the third. Now the catcher batting ninth today, Sean Williams. Sean Williams looking to get it going this year. Four games thus far, batting .143 with two RBIs, comes up with Padilla on first and nobody out. He takes a fastball up for ball number one. Padilla leads off first, and the 1-0 fastball inside and hits him. The 19th hit by pitch for the Ducks this year, and they have runners on first and second to lead off the bottom of the third for DJ Christian. Courtesy running for Sean Williams at first base. Cam Carroll, he's getting the day off today after playing in each of the first seven games. Now up DJ Christian playing left field today. He takes a first pitch slider on the inner half for strike number one. Christian threw two games, 1-for-6 on a stolen base. He comes up with nobody out and runners on first and second. 0-1 fastball ripped into center. Sweat will field it on a bounce. Gaudino, the head coach, will hold Padilla at third. Runners go station to station, and the Ducks have the bases loaded for the top of the order and Dom Presto. DJ Christian takes that fastball, ripped it into center. Hit too hard, though, for Padilla to score from second. Now the bases are loaded for the leadoff batter, Dom Presto, who walked in the first, now up with no out in the third. He takes the first pitch slider and fouls it over to the right side. The second baseman, Platt, lets it drop in foul territory for strike number one. Santo goes to the slider there to lead off Presto after Christian took the fastball into center field. Santo going from the full windup with the bases loaded and nobody out. Corners are in for the Barracudas. Santo blows a fastball right by Presto. Now the count 0-2 to the shortstop. Barracudas will try to turn a double play up the middle. Corners are in to try to prevent the run if it's hit to third or first. Santo into the windup, and the 0-2 slider sits low. Count now 1-2 to Presto. One-two fastball low, 2-2 now the count to the leadoff hitter. Presto with three RBIs already through six games, looking to add that total here with the bases loaded. And the 2-2 slider in there on the outside corner for strike three looking. Santo, nice job getting the slider on the outside corner for strike three looking. And the first out here in the bottom of the third, but the bases are still loaded for the extra hitter, Brad Hart. He grounded into a 4-4-3 double play in the first, looking to do something here in the third. Barracudas will leave the corners in and will try to turn a double play up the middle. First pitch to Hart, fastball grounded up the middle. Shortstop McLaughlin will come on and field. He won't have a play at second. He'll have to go to first. We'll get the out there, but the Ducks do get a run as Padilla scores from first, and they lead 1-0 here in the bottom of the third. So not the prettiest RBI for Brad Hart, but an RBI nonetheless as he got a piece of that, but hit it too slow for the shortstop to turn two. And the Ducks lead 1-0 here in the third. Now runners on a second and third with two outs. Joey Urban takes a fastball for strike number one on the inner half. DJ Christian at second. And Cam Carroll, courtesy running for Williams, at third. Santos 0-1, fastball taken into left. Edwards drifts back and puts it away for out number three, but the Ducks do get one here in the bottom of the third and lead 1-0 after three. Welcome back here to the top of the fourth. Robbie Troop back out on the mound. Face the top of the order here for the Barracudas in the top of the fourth. Kyle Platt back up. He struck out to lead off the first inning, now leads off the fourth. The first pitch fastball he sees grounded over to Frank at second. He fields it and throws on to Vida at first. One out in the fourth inning. Now up the center fielder, Tanner Sweat, struck out in the first inning as Troop struck out recorded all three outs in the first inning via the strikeout. Now comes up with one out in the fourth. Troop into the windup. His first pitch fastball. Line back just off his mitt. He chases it. Throws on to first. He holds it because he wouldn't have gotten it there in time. And that is the first hit of the game for the Barracudas. And they have a runner on first base with one out in the top of the fourth. Absolute laser right back to Robbie Troop at first at the pitcher's mound. Looked like he almost had it tipped out of his mitt. Infield single there for Tanner Sweat. Now up Kyle Machado. He's hit by a pitch in the first inning. He swings and misses at the fastball on the outer half for strike number one. Troop comes set at the belt. He goes submarine fastball fouled straight back for strike number two. Troop's 0-2 fastball lifted into center. Back goes Q in center, but he'll settle under it, and that'll be the second out of the inning. Sweat goes back to first. Now up the first baseman, Chris Scholler. Sweat on first base for the first baseman, Chris Scholler. Struck out swinging in his first at-bat in the first, now put two outs in the fourth. Troop's first pitch just misses off the outside half for ball number one. Sweat, not a big lead at first. Troop's 1-0 fastball below the knees. 2-0 now the count to the first baseman. Barracudas and Diamond Ducks are both bottom half in the league in stolen bases. Sweat not a huge lead at first here with two outs. Troop's 2-0. Oh, but he's on the move. Troop's 2-0 fastball lifted into left. Christian settles under it and records the third out. The Barracudas get one hit, but get no runs as we go to the bottom of the fourth. Ducks lead 1-0. Welcome back to the bottom of the fourth. Diamond Ducks lead 1-0 here at Joe Russo Field. And we'll have Joey Cicini, the designated hitter, leading it off as Nick Santo is back out for his fourth inning to start this one. Cicini hot through his first five games, batting over 300. He popped out to the second baseman in the second, now leads off the fourth for the Ducks against Nick Santo. Santo into the windup. His first pitch fastball in there for called strike one on the inner half. Santos 0-1 in the dirt, brings the count even to 1-1 on the designated hitter. Santo into the windup. His 1-1 slider misses low. Check swing did not go. Cicini did not. 2-1 the count. 2-1 fastball just early on that is Cicini. He fouls it off down the left field line and out of play. 2-2 now the count to lead off the bottom of the fourth. Two two off speed in the dirt brings the count full 3-2 to lead off the fourth inning for the Ducks. Joey Cicini at the plate and Jack Q, the center fielder, on deck. Santos 3-2 inside ball four. His third walk on the day. Second straight inning with the leadoff walk for the Ducks, and Jack Q, the center fielder, now up. Before we get started with Jack Q's at bat, we'll get a mound visit from the Barracudas. Long conversation from the manager. Now walking back to the dugout. Now Jack Q up. He reached on an error by the shortstop McLaughlin in the second. Advanced to second on that same error, but was stranded there. Now comes up with nobody out. And Joey Cicini on first base. Santo checks in on Cicini at first. Nice hops by Scholler at first base to save an error. Santo will reset, and his first pitch to Q, slider swung on and missed for strike number one. Goldfine will throw behind Cicini at first, but he is safe there. 0-1 the count to Jack Q. Santo's 0-1 fastball elevated at that time, swung on and missed. 0-2 quickly the count to the center fielder with nobody out. Santo checks in on Cicini once more. He dives back in safely. Santo's 0-2 fastball lined over to Platt at second. He'll field it. Go on to short. McLaughlin gets the out at second. His throw to Scholler at first is late. So a fielder's choice for Jack Q. One out now in the fourth. So nice play by Platt, who had to go to his left to field that. Flipped his feet through on to second to get the first out of the inning there. Q now at first, and Cole Vida at the plate. Flew out to the center fielder in his first at-bat. Santo will check in on Q at first, but they rule it a balk, so Q will get second. So Q gets second on the balk. Now a runner in scoring position with one out for Cole Vida. Santo's first pitch slider in on the inner half for strike number one to the first baseman. 0-1 pitch from Santo is a fastball fouled off for strike number two. Santo comes set. His 0-2 divider, slider on the inner half, swung on and missed. Nice back foot slider to get Vida to swing and miss in the dirt for out number two here in the bottom of the fourth. Now up the second baseman out of FAU, Dalton Frank, looking to get Jack Q in from second here with two outs in the bottom of the fourth. Nick Santo comes set. And his first pitch to Frank is a fastball that hits the outside corner for strike number one. The 0-1 slider on the inner half misses, brings the count even to 1-1 on Frank. Q leads off second. The 1-1 fastball from Santo lifted into center. Sweat comes on and puts it away for out number three. We are through four. Ducks lead 1-0 over the Barracudas. Welcome back to Joe Russo Field as we are quickly through four here and headed to the top of the fifth at Joe Russo Field between the Phipps Park Barracudas and the Palm Beach Diamond Ducks. Let's take a trip around the SFCBL very quickly. In the bottom of the sixth, the West Palm Beach Knights lead the Boca Raton Blazers 3-1 at Little Fenway. And the Ducks lead the Barracudas here 1-0 as we head to the top of the fifth. And Robbie Troop back out on the mound. Five strikeouts through four innings. And he faces Dylan Edwards to start things off here in the fifth. Edwards was one of Troop's strikeout victims back in the second. Fouls off the first pitch fastball for strike number one. Troop recorded his first four outs via the strikeout. Didn't have one in the fourth. Now looking to add to that total here in the fifth. Already has Edwards in an 0-1 hole. Submarine fastball popped up on the infield. Frank calls off Vida at second. He puts it away for the first out in the top of the fifth. Nice job by Troop going to the submarine action to catch Edwards off guard. Now up Colton McCautry. He reached on an error by Dalton Frank at second in the second inning, now looking to lead things off with a one out in the fourth, in the fifth. He lifts this for the first pitch foul off to the left side. 0-1 now the count on the designated hitter. McCautry choking up on the bat. His 0-1 fastball just misses on the inside half, runs the count even at 1-1. Troop into the windup. Two-seam fastball slash changeup misses on the outside half. 2-1 now the count. Looked more like a changeup than a two-seam fastball. Drifted off to the outside half to the lefty. Now Troop's 2-1. Fastball swung on and missed. Runs the count back even at 2-2 to McCautry. Slider on the inside half. Launch to right field. That'll get down. McCautry will go to second. Padilla gets it in from right. And that's a one-out double for Colton McCautry. Robbie Troop left the slider up and in to the designated hitter, McCautry. He jumps out in front, launches that to right field for a double. Now up the shortstop, Dylan McLaughlin, with a runner on second and one out for the Barracudas. Troop goes to the inside move. Frank's not at second, so he'll reset on the mound and get ready for his first pitch to McLaughlin, who grounded out to the second baseman Frank in the second. His first pitch fastball in there at the knees. Nice frame by the catcher Williams to get the knees. 0-1 the count to the shortstop. Troop comes set. And the 0-1 fastball in on the inside half. Quickly 0-2 to McLaughlin here with one out in the top of the fifth. And Colton McCautry at second base. O2 fastball grounded through the third base shortstop hole. DJ Christian will charge in left. That will hold McCautry at third. First and third now with back-to-back hits here for the Barracudas in the fifth. Troop got ahead 0-2 on McLaughlin, went to the fastball in the outer half, and McLaughlin went right with it into left field. Two straight hits for the Barracudas. Runners on first and third for Max Goldfein, the catcher. Goldfein flew out to Presto in short left field, his first at-bat. Goes to the submarine. They'll safety squeeze. Vida will have no play. What a great bunt from Goldfein. Late square on the safety squeeze by Goldfein. Vida had to charge. Nobody covered first. And the Barracudas will score the runner from third. Now 1-1 here in the top of the fifth. And runners on first and second and one out. Now up Gabriel Rodriguez. He flew out to the center field, the left fielder in the third. Now up with runners on first and second and one out here in the fifth. Troop's first pitch on the inside half. Misses for ball number one. Troop's 1-0 slider misses outside. 2-0 now the count to the extra hitter. Troop will regroup on the backside of the mound, get some rosin on his arm, and then step back on the mound with a 2-0 count to Rodriguez. Troop's 2-0 fastball on the outside half, swung on and missed. 2-1 the count to Rodriguez. McLaughlin on second, Goldfein on first, and one out. Troop comes set. He'll look the runner McLaughlin back to second. Back on the rubber. Troop comes set. 2-1 the count. And his 2-1 pitch. Fastball nicks the outside corner. Brings the count back even to 2-2. Troops 2-2 fastball lifted. That'll get down in center. Q will charge. They'll send the runner from third. It's bobbled. And the throw will go into second. Another run will score. Goldfine holds at second base. And now the Barracudas lead 2-1 here in the fifth. Four straight hits for the Barracudas. They lead 2-1 here in the fifth, still with runners on first and second and one out. First pitch fastball sits high for ball number one to Joe DeNorcia. He struck out in his first at-bat in the third. Now comes up with Goldfine on second and Rodriguez on first and one out here in the top of the fifth. 1-0 fastball down and inside, fouled off to the left, brings the count even to 1-1 on the right fielder. Troop comes set. His 1-1 slider gets the outside half. 1-2 now the count to the right fielder. As the Barracudas have done it all, four straight hits here in the fifth. One bunt single to get a run in, and then an inside jam shot that got down in the outfield to get the other run in. Troop misses with a changeup up. 2-2 now the count to DeNorcia. The 2-2 fastball swung on and fouled. Williams can't corral it back there behind the plate, so the count will remain 2-2. Troops 2-2 once more. Slider gets him swinging on the inside half for strike number three, his sixth strikeout on the day. And that's the second out here in the fifth for the top of the order and Tanner Sweat. Nice slider there by Troop, running in on the left-hander DeNorcia to get him swinging. And now up the leadoff hitter and the second baseman, Tanner Sweat, 0-2 on the day. Runners on first and second. Troop goes to the submarine to get the first pitch in there for strike number one on the second baseman. Troop comes set. 0-1 submarine fastball outside. Nice job by Williams behind the plate to get out there to prevent the runners from advancing. 1-1 now the count on Platt. Correction, Kyle Platt at the dish. Tanner Sweat on deck. 1-1 changeup on the inside half for strike number two. Three straight submarine pitches from Robbie Troop, keeping Kyle Platt a little off balance here with two outs. 1-2 regular three-quarters arm slot, foul tipped. Back behind home plate, 1-2 remains the count here. With two outs, the Barracudas already have two in here in the top of the fifth. One, two, misses away. 2-2, the count to the second baseman. Troop looked to slip a little bit there on the follow-through. He'll fill in a hole on the pitcher's mound and step back on the rubber. Troop's 2-2, submarine again. That's low. And I guess it hit him in the foot. So a hit by pitch for Platt, and the bases will be loaded for the Barracudas here with two outs. Now up Tanner Sweat. He's 1-2 with a single in his last bat in the fourth. Now comes up with the bases loaded in the fifth. Robbie Troop will go from the full windup here with the bases loaded. Goes with this changeup there on pitch number one, fouled off for strike one. Yeah. Troop into the windup. 0-1 fastball misses on the outer half, brings the count back even to 1-1 on the center fielder. Sweat with one RBI so far this season, looking to add to that total here with the bases full. 1-1 to him, fastball grounded past the first baseman, Vida. Padilla will chase it into the corner. One run scores easily. Rodriguez scores from second. And Platt goes to third on the two RBI double for the Barracudas. So two more for the Barracudas, four runs in the inning. They now lead 4-1 in the fifth, with runners now on second and third, and still two outs. Kyle Machado now up. He dribbles a slider foul for strike number one. Ground ball just got past the mitt of Vida. Padilla chased it into the corner and right. Two runs scored easily as Platt moved to third. And now Sweat on second for Kyle Machado. Troop uses the full windup, goes with the submarine, and gets the fastball in there on the outer half. Now 0-2 to the third baseman. Troop's 0-2. Fastball lifted in play. Behind first base, Frank will call Vida off and put it away for the final out of the top of the fifth. But the Barracudas get four and now lead 4-1 as we are halfway through and head to the bottom half of the fifth inning. Welcome back here to the bottom of the fifth. The Barracudas took the lead in the top half of the inning with five hits, two doubles, scored four runs, now lead 4-1 going into the bottom half of the fifth with Levi Padilla leading it off for the Ducks. Padilla walked to lead off the third and now leads off the fifth for the Ducks as they now face a three-run deficit and look to mount a comeback. Nick Santo back out on the mound. His first pitch, elevated fastball to Padilla, fouled off for strike number one. One curveball misses on the outside half. 1-1 now to lead off the bottom of the fifth to the right fielder. 1-1 fastball hits the inside corner for strike number two. Santo into the windup, goes with the 1-2 curveball, misses outside, brings the count back even at 2-2 to Padilla. Santo's 2-2 fastball sits low. Full count to lead off here in the bottom of the fifth, and Levi Padilla at the plate. Santos 3-2 fastball popped up. Second baseman Platt goes back, called off by the right fielder DeNorcia. He puts it away for the first out in the bottom half of the fifth. Now up to catcher Sean Williams. First pitch slider fouled off to the left side for strike number one. He was hit by a pitch in the third, got all the way to third base but was stranded there. Now up with one out here in the fifth. Santo goes back to the slider on 0-1. He misses in the dirt there to bring it even to 1-1 on the catcher. Santo working fast here, back into the windup. Goes back to the slider again. Misses on the inside part of the plate this time. 2-1 now to Williams. Santos 2-1 fastball popped up on the infield. Back goes the first baseman Scholler. He'll call it and catch it in fair territory for out number two. Now up the center fielder, the left fielder, DJ Christian. He singled in the third. And his takes a first pitch off speed for strike number one. The ball went into the outfield. Got me a little bit confused there. But the catcher just overthrew the pitcher on the throw back. So they'll get that ball in there. DJ Christian singled into center field on a fastball on 0-1 in his last at-bat. He's 0-1 here. Let's see if Santo goes back to the fastball on this one. Santo into the windup. Goes with the curveball on 0-1 here. Drops it in there for a called strike number two. So Santo changing up there, going with the curveball up 0-2 quickly to DJ Christian. Goes the curveball again on 0-2, but Christian goes right with it between the shortstop and the third baseman, and he has a two-out single to bring up Dom Presto for the Ducks. Presto 0-for-1 on the day with a walk in the first and a strikeout looking in the third. Now up with DJ Christian at first base in the fifth. Christian with one stolen base but in two games, so he has got some speed. He'll dive back in there as Santo checks in on him. He's safe with two outs here. And Dom Presto up would be a great opportunity to steal for Christian, as it would bring Presto, it would bring Presto, the leadoff batter, up to lead off the sixth. Santo checks in on Christian once more. Now we'll step back on the rubber and work with Presto. Come set. Christian not on the move. Presto takes his fifth hit by pitch of the year. League leading fifth hit by pitch. And he will go to first now with two outs and two runners on for the Ducks. So I've come to the conclusion that Dom Presto enjoys being hit by the pitch. He led the league going in today with four, adds to that total with his fifth to put two runners on for the Ducks here with two outs. And Brad Hart coming to the plate. We'll get a mound visit from the Barracudas. And they will leave pitcher Nick Santo in to face the extra hitter, Brad Hart. He grounded it into a 4-4-3 double play in the first. Grounded out to the shortstop in the third. Got the RBI on that ground out to the shortstop in the third. Looking for an RBI single possibly to score Christian from second here in the fifth.
Ducks do have some action in the bullpen. Robbie Troop might be done after five innings, but we'll have to wait till the next inning to find out who that is. Anyway, Nick Santo, first pitch curveball in there for a called strike on Brad Hart. Santo comes set. His 0-1 fastball elevated, swung on, and missed. 0-2 quickly to the extra hitter. So goes curveball on the first pitch, elevates the fastball on the second pitch. Watch out for the curveball once more, maybe in the dirt, because he's ahead 0-2 on Brad Hart with DJ Christian at second base and Dom Presto at first. Santo goes to the slider, not in the dirt, but on the inner half, just misses below the knees. 1-2 now the count to Brad Hart. Santo comes set at the belt. And the 1-2 fastball just misses below the knees, runs the count even at 2-2 with here with two outs in the bottom of the fifth. Presto on first, DJ Christian on second base. And the 2-2 to Brad Hart. Curveball doesn't curve enough. Hits in by the pitch. Two straight hit by pitches drawn by the Ducks, and they will have the bases loaded for the three-hitter Joey Urban. And we will have a pitching change here for the Barracudas as the Ducks have the bases loaded. Their third hit-by-pitch of the game, that'll add to the total. Now 21 on the season. They have the bases loaded and Joey Urban up with two outs. We'll be back right after this pitching change. Welcome back here to the bottom of the fifth inning at Joe Russo Field. Salvatore Zaremba now on the mound out of St. Thomas University. He's pitched in what game? Two innings, two hits, five earned runs, three walks, and two Ks, replacing Nick Santo, who looked to be cruising through the fifth inning, got the first two outs, gave up a single to DJ Christian, then hit Presto and Hart back-to-back. And now Zaremba comes in trying to bail him out of a bases-loaded two-out jam. Santo responsible for Christian at third, Presto at second, and Hart at first, so the book's not fully closed on him. And the third baseman, Joey Urban, coming to the plate in his third at-bat. He's 0-2, flown out to the left fielder and the center fielder so far. Will be the first batter to greet Zaremba. Garemba in warmouts was showcasing the three-quarter arm slot, kind of like what Troop was doing a little bit earlier. And he will step on the rubber to face Joey Urban with the bases loaded, two outs. DJ Christian at third, Presto at second, and Brad Hart at first base. Garemba comes set. And his first pitch to Urban, grounded over to third base. Machado misses it, and he is off the base at first, safe. Two runs will come in to score. DJ Christian scored on the ground ball. Presto kept going around third on the throw. He will score as well. And that's a two RBI reach on an error, so no RBIs, but two runs score. And the Ducks trim this lead to one for the Barracudas, now 4-3 in the bottom of the fifth. A ground ball that Machado, put the wrong score in the scoreboard. 4-3, my bad. Ground ball that Machado waited on at third base, took a bad hop. Looked like he recovered. His throw was a little bit wide of the base. Drew Schuller off. So Urban at first. Hart moved up to second on that play. Still two outs. Garemba gets a first pitch strike in on Joey Cicini, who comes up 0-for-1. Drew a walk in the fourth inning. Four RBIs in the last 2 days, though. And he has Brad Hart in scoring position with two outs. Zaremba's 0-1 two-seamer gets the outside corner quickly, 0-2 to the designated hitter. Nice job by Presto running the bases. Rounded third with authority and came in to score on the throwing error. 0-2 now, Zaremba. Curveball grounded up the middle. McLaughlin ranges over and gets the out at second base as Platt covered. But the Ducks get two, and now the Barracuda's lead is 4-3 as we are through five here at Joe Russo Field. Welcome back, everybody, to the top of the sixth. We have a new pitcher on the mound for the Ducks, Andrew Ward, number 39 out of Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University. Ward was supposed to come into the game to close it out against the Boca Raton Blazers before the Sprinklers ended the game through eight innings. He now gets his second appearance on the year. First one back last Sunday against the Extreme. One innings pitched, a walk, got the win in that one, and now comes in with the Ducks down 4-3 in the sixth. First pitch from Ward, low for ball number one. Top of the order back up for the Barracudas with Kyle Platt. One oh fastball in there for a called strike. 1-1 now the count to Platt. One one fastball sits low. 2-1 the count to the second baseman. Ward comes set. His 2-1 fastball misses high. 3-1 now the count to Platt leading off. Excuse me. Platt is not up. Scholler, the four hitter, is up. 2-1 or 3-1 the count to Scholler. Pitch is high and over Scholler's head, so a leadoff walk for the Barracudas here in the sixth by Scholler. Book is closed on Robbie Troop. 5 innings pitched, 6 hits, 4 earned runs, no walks, and 6 Ks. Ran into trouble there in the fifth. Now Andrew Ward on for the sixth as he walks the leadoff batter, and now up Dylan Edwards. Dylan 0-for-2 on the day, a strikeout back in the second, and popped out to the second baseman last inning in the fifth. Now comes up with a runner on first and nobody out. In the fifth, fastball low. Nice block by Williams to keep Scholler at first base. 1-0 the count to Edwards. Ward comes set. Runners on the move. Fastball in the dirt. Scooped by Williams. He will steal the base because the ball was in the dirt. That's a stolen base for Scholler. The Barracudas have a runner on second now with nobody out and a 2-0 count to Edwards here in the sixth. Ducks do have someone beginning to warm up in the bullpen. We will get the number as soon as possible. Andrew Ward's fastball sits low, 3-0. Now to Edwards, and Ward's in danger of walking the first two batters here in the sixth. From Ward in there and hits Edwards. So a walk and a hit by pitch has runners on first and second to lead off the top of the sixth. Now up the DH, Colton McCautry. He doubled and came in to score the first Barracudas run last inning in the fifth. Now up here in the sixth with runners on first and second and nobody out. Rolling up the sleeves a little bit here at the plate, showing off the guns. Maybe trying to get rid of the farmer's tan, however. This game is at night, and there is no sun out. So, 0-1, a fastball on the inside half, fouled out of play for strike number one. So Ward in some trouble here in the sixth, walked the first batter, hit the second batter, although he was 3-0 on him. Now facing McCautry here with one out. He launches it into the outfield. The center fielder Q calls him off. Tagging at second is Scholler. He'll get to third on the sacrifice fly as Edwards remains at first base. So sac fly there for McCautry. Scholler to third. First and third now with one out here in the sixth for Dylan McLaughlin. Ducks will play the infield back to try and turn two. Vida holds on. Edwards at first. Ward's first pitch to McLaughlin in the dirt. Nice block by Williams once again to hold the runners at bay. Ward comes set. His 1-0 on the inside half. Ball, though, 2-0 now the count to McLaughlin. Just missed on the inside half of the fastball. 2-0 the count. Ward struggling to throw strikes here in the sixth. Was 3-0 to Edwards. Walked Scholler. Now 2-0 to McLaughlin. Now 3-0 to McLaughlin with one out. Out to McLaughlin. Bats low. Nice block by Williams. Four pitch walk to McLaughlin. The second of the inning for Ward. And the bases are loaded for the catcher, Max Goldfein. So Ward struggling to find the strike zone, but now nowhere to go. Bases loaded for Max Goldfein. He singled in the fifth, part of four straight hits for the Barracudas in the fifth. He flew out to the shortstop in the third, so 1-for-2 on the day. First pitch, fastball swung on and missed for strike number one. So Goldfein gets the green light after a four-pitch walk from Ward to McLaughlin. Ward now set 0-1. His pitch, fastball misses up, brings the count back even to 1-1. One fastball ripped to Presto at short. He'll corral that for out number two, but a loud out number two off the bat of Max Goldfein. Levi Padilla has moved over to center field with Jack Q now in right. Now up, Dexter hitter Gabriel Rodriguez takes the curveball high on the first pitch. 1-0 the count. Fastball low as well. 2-0 now the count. As Ward is running out of room here. Bases loaded, 2-0 to the extra hitter. Ward comes in and hits him by the pitch. Second RBI of the day for Rodriguez on the hit by pitch. And the Barracudas now lead 5-3 here in the sixth with two outs. Rodriguez takes it on the back there for the RBI. Everyone moves up a base. Edwards the third. McLaughlin to second, and then Rodriguez to first. Ward now works to Joe DeNorcia, the right fielder. He swings and misses at a fastball for strike number one. Two strikeouts for DeNorcia, one in the third, one in the fifth. He's looking to get off the schneid in this one. 0-1 the count. 0-1, grounded over to Frank at second. He'll talk Stipresto at second base. And that will end the inning. The Barracudas do get one, though. Now lead 5-3 as we head to the bottom of the sixth. Welcome back here for the bottom of the sixth, everyone. Let's get you caught up on maybe some major league action that you're missing out on while watching some Diamond Ducks baseball. The Brewers lead the Mets 3-1 in the top of the fifth. Braves up on the Nationals 3-0, also in the top of the fifth. In the top of the sixth, the Yankees are up on the Rays 4-0. Earlier today, the Phillies defeated the Marlins 3-1. And an absolute thrashing in Detroit. The White Sox defeated the Tigers 13-0. Back to the bottom of the sixth, though. Jack Q leading off for the Diamond Ducks. Ducks got a two-out rally started with DJ Christian in the fifth. We're able to scratch off two runs. Now go to the sixth, down 5-3 with Jack Q leading it off. Reached twice today, once on an error in the second, the other in the fourth on a fielder's choice. Zaremba back out on the mound for the Barracudas. First pitch, fastball low for ball number one to Jack Q. Book is closed on the starter, Nick Santo. 4 2/3, one hit, two earned runs, three walks, two strikeouts. And the 1-0 from Zaremba, fastball in at the knees. Brings the count even to 1-1 on the center fielder. Excuse me, the right fielder now, Jack Q. One fastball dribbled over to third. Machado fields it, throws on to shoulder, and he beats it out. Machado a little bit lackadaisical there at third. Jack Q beats out the infield single for a leadoff single for the Ducks here in the sixth. Great hustle there by Jack Q. It was a nice scoop also by Scholler at first, but the throw is not in time. Now up the first baseman, Cole Vida, 0-2 on the day. Flew out to the left fielder in the second and struck out in the fourth. First pitch to Vida inside for ball number one. Zaremba comes set. Q on the move. The 1-0 pitch driven into the outfield. DeNorcia chases in right, but the sweat, the center fielder, will get it about a couple strides from the wall. And Q will go back to first. Now one out in the bottom of the sixth. So hit and run there for the Ducks doesn't work out. Cue back to first with one out, and Dalton Frank up at the plate. Two flyouts, one to the left fielder, one to the center fielder, now up in the sixth. Zaremba checks over at Q. He's safe at first. We'll reset for the first pitch to Dalton Frank here in the bottom of the sixth. First pitch to Frank is a fastball in there for called strike number one. Vida put a drive into that one. The center fielder, though, plenty of room. Caught it for the first out. Frank now down 0-1. Zaremba will check in at Q with Q again. He's safe. Still 0-1 with one out. The 0-1 fastball in the dirt. Dirt ball read by Q, and he will get to second base. Nice block by Goldfein, but the throw was behind Platt at second, and Q gets in there on the wild pitch. One-one the count to Frank. Frank looking for his second RBI with Q in scoring position at second base. 1-1 fastball grounded over to Machado at third. He fields it, throws on to Scholler at first. And that's the second out here in the bottom of the sixth. Now up the center fielder, Levi Padilla, got on base in the third with a walk, came in to score the first Diamond Ducks run, flew out to right field in the fifth. Now up with Jack Q in scoring position and two outs in the sixth. Zaremba's first pitch to Padilla in on the inner half for strike number one. Zaremba will step off and reset on the rubber. He comes set. Zaremba's 0-1. Fastball grounded into the hole. McLaughlin ranges over at short. Throws on to first. Nice scoop by Scholler at first base. And that will end the sixth. Barracudas lead 5-3 as we are through six. And we head to the top of the seventh here at Joe Russo Field. Welcome back to the pond, a.k.a. Joe Russo Field here for the top of the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound for the Diamond Ducks out of Carson Newman University, number 29, Steele Gately. The right-hander has pitched in two games, pitched two innings total, and three Ks with no hits allowed. Got two saves in those two outings. He comes on in the seventh this time, replacing Andrew Ward. Ward went one inning, no hits, an earned run on two walks, no strikeouts. Two hit-by-pitches is what did him in the sixth. Now on to pitch Steele Gately. He will face the top of the order here for the Barracudas. The second baseman, Kyle Platt. Platt hit by a pitch in the fifth, 0-for-2 on the day, strikeout in the first, ground out to the second baseman in the fourth. Now leads things off for the Barracudas in the seventh, but not before a mound visit by the catcher Williams. Make sure to get on the same page with signs with Gately. Gately into the windup. First pitch fastball up. Platt bluffs a bunt. Ball number one. Gately's 1-0 fastball lined over the head of Presto. That'll get in for a leadoff single here in the seventh. Platt's first hit on the day, and that brings up Tanner Sweat here with a runner on first and nobody out in the seventh. He's 2-for-3 on the day, a 2-RBI double in the fifth, a single in the fourth, struck out in the first, but now comes up with nobody out in the seventh. Gately's first pitch to Sweat, off speed, just misses low, ball number one. Gately will check in on Platt at first. That'll get by Vida. Platt goes to second. Will go all the way to third as the ball rolls all the way to the fence in foul territory. That is a two-base error by the pitcher, Steele Gately, on the pickoff attempt. Gately tried to pick off Platt at first. Low throw got by Vida. Two-base error. And now Platt on third with Sweat still up and a 1-0 count. Ducks will bring their infield in here with nobody out in the seventh. Gately will go from the full windup, and his 1-0 fastball is high for ball number two. Gately's 2-0 fastball high as well. 3-0 now the count to Sweat. With the three-hitter Machado on deck. Gately's 3-0 fastball sits high once more. Four-pitch walk. So two straight base runners here for the Barracudas to lead off the seventh, and now the first baseman, Machado, who's 0-for-2, reached in the first on a hit-by-pitch, but flew out to the center fielder and popped out to the second baseman in the fourth and fifth. Ducks will drop their middle infielders back to turn two on a ground ball. Corners remain in, though, with nobody out. Gately's first pitch curveball in the dirt. Sweat will go to second on the in the dirt. Sweat will go to second on the wild pitch. Williams threw to first. Then Vida decided to hold it and let Sweat advance to second to hold Platt at third base. So
So runners on second and third now with nobody out and Machado up. Ducks will leave their middle infielders back and their corners in. First pitch fastball sits high. Now 2-0 the count to Machado. Fastball high once more now, 3-0 and 7 straight balls from Steele Gately. Fastball in there for a called strike. 3-1 the count now to the third baseman with Kyle Platt at third and Tanner Sweat at second, and nobody out. The 3-1, a fastball grounded foul, runs the count full to Machado, 3-2. Gately into the windup. His 3-2 fastball lifted foul off to the right side and out of play. 3-2 remains the count. Gately into the windup once again. 3-2 slider this time in the dirt. Second straight walk by Gately, and the bases are loaded for the cleanup hitter, Chris Scholler. Still nobody out in the seventh. Nobody warming up in the Ducks bullpen. This is all Steele Gately's inning. He will have to try to work out of trouble. The bases are loaded, nobody out. The first baseman, Chris Scholler, now up. First pitch fastball ripped into left field. DJ Christian will charge and field it. Platt scores. Sweat comes in right behind him as the throw is not in time. Machado moves up to second. A 2-RBI single by Chris Scholler. And the Barracudas now lead 7-3 in the seventh. First pitch fastball ripped over the third baseman's head there. A 2-RBI single from Scholler. Now up the left fielder, Edwards. Still nobody out here in the seventh. And the Barracudas lead 7-3. First pitch slider in there for a called strike number one on Edwards. Goes back to the curveball for strike number two. 0-2 the count quickly to the left fielder. Still nobody out and runners on first and second. O-2 slider off the outside half. 1-2 now the count to Edwards. One-two fastball just misses off the outside part of the plate. Runs the count back even to 2-2. Two-two slider swung on and missed for strike three and the first out here in the top of the seventh. After coming in with the fastball, goes right back to the slider to get Edwards swinging. Edwards' second strikeout on the day. Now up Colton McCautry, the designated hitter. Doubled in the fifth to start their four-run rally in that inning, now up with runners on first and second and one out in the seventh. He takes a changeup low for ball number one. Misses just off the outside half and low. Gately comes set at the belt. He steps off and resets. 1-0 count to the designated hitter. One-oh fastball in there on the outer half. 1-1 now the count to McCautry. One-one fastball ripped into center field. Back goes Padilla. He'll catch it and throw in. Machado does not tag from second. Now two outs here in the seventh on a hard line drive out by McCautry. McCautry got the fastball there, lined it, but right to the center fielder. Two outs now for Dylan McLaughlin. McLaughlin has reached base his latter two at-bats. He's 1-for-2, a single in the fifth, a walk in the sixth. Takes strike number one on the outer half. 0-1 the count. Gailey goes back to the curveball for strike number two. Quickly 0-2 to the shortstop here. Two outs, runners on first and second. Machado on second and Scholler on first. 0-2 off speed, swung on and missed. Gately's second strikeout of the inning, but the Barracudas get two to extend their lead to 7-3, and we reach the seventh inning stretch. Anybody who's watching, get up from your tablet, iPhone, or laptop, whatever you're watching on. Stretch a little bit, and we'll rejoin you for the bottom of the seventh just after this. Welcome back, everybody, to the bottom of the seventh. Barracudas lead 7-3 with Sean Williams coming to the plate to lead off for the Ducks. Ducks have gotten double-digit runs in back-to-back days. They'll need some of that magic at the plate to come back on the Barracudas here at Joe Russo Field. And it'll start with Sean Williams, hit by a pitch in the third, popped out to the first baseman in the fifth, now leads off the seventh for the Ducks. Williams grounds it just past Machado at third. He has a leadoff single here in the seventh for the Ducks. Cam Carroll will run for Sean Williams once again at first base.
Ducks have a runner on first and nobody out for DJ Christian, who already has two singles, one in the third and one in the fifth. Came in to score the third Ducks run in the fifth. Now up in the seventh, and Dom Presto, the leadoff hitter, on deck. Zrember will check in on Carroll at first. He is safe. And we'll reset with DJ Christian at the plate. Zremba's first pitch to Christian. Changeup swung on and missed. Christian was out in front of the changeup there. 0-1 the count to the left fielder. Carroll dives back in at first base. He's safe once more. Zremba 0-1 on DJ Christian. And Zaremba's pitch, fastball low, swung on and missed for strike two. Christian pulling off on the first two pitches, now down 0-2 quickly here with nobody out in the bottom of the seventh. Christian choking up on the bout with the 0-2 count. And his 0-2 changeup grounded over to Scholler at first. He throws, and it's wide of McLaughlin at short. And Christian will reach. So Christian reaches on the fielder's choice error by the first baseman Scholler. And the Ducks have two base runners to start the seventh and the top of the order. And Dom Presto coming to the plate. Presto's reached base twice today. A walk in the first, a hit by pitch in the fifth, came in to score the second Ducks run in the fifth. Now looking to do some damage here in the seventh. Zremba's first pitch to Presto. Another changeup has him out in front, swinging 0-1 quickly to Presto. One change up to Presto once more. He fouls that off to the left side this time. Quickly 0-2 to the shortstop. Nobody out. Cam Carroll courtesy running for Sean Williams at second and DJ Christian at first, and nobody out in the bottom of the seventh. Zremba steps off. And we'll step back out on the rubber. Reset on Presto. Zremba comes set at the shoulders. And his 0-2 changeup in the dirt brings the count to 1-2 on Presto. Cam Carroll dancing a little bit there at second base. Had Zremba looking at him. 1-2 the count to Presto. The 1-2 to Presto. In there, hit by pitch. Another hit by pitch for Dom Presto. His second of the game, and the Ducks will have the bases loaded here in the seventh. Presto now 6 hit by pitches drawn on the year. The bases are loaded with nobody out for Brad Hart. RBI ground out in the third, looking to add to that total on the day. Nobody out Cam Carroll at third, DJ Christian at second, and Dom Presto at first. Corners will come in for the Barracudas, try and cut down the run if it's hit to the hot corners. And they will play back in the middle and try to turn two if it's hit to the shortstop or the second baseman on the ground. Zaremba's first pitch to Hart, just below the knees for ball number one. Zaremba's 1-0 in the dirt, gets by the catcher Goldfine, and Carroll will come in to score. 7-4 now, the Barracudas lead in the seventh. Everyone moves up the base on the wild pitch. Ducks now have runners on second and third with nobody out in the seventh. Brad Hart still at the plate with a 2-0 count. Middle infielders will remain back. Hot corners will stay in. 2-0 the count on Brad Hart. Hart calls time in the batter's box. Will reset. Zaremba comes set. And the 2-0 nicks the outside half for strike number one. Machado playing even with the base at third, shoulder in at the cut of the grass at first. Zaremba's 2-1 fastball grounded over to the shortstop McLaughlin. He'll field it and throw. It's wide of first base, but nice tag by Scholler to get the first out of the inning. DJ Christian will come in to score as the Ducks cut it to two here in the seventh inning. Nice tag over there by Scholler at first to get the out. Now the Barracudas lead is trimmed to 7-5 here in the bottom of the seventh, and Dom Presto still at third base and only one out for Joey Urban. Barracudas will play their entire infield back, will concede the run on the ground ball as Zaremba comes set. His first pitch to Urban in the dirt, nice block by Goldfine behind the plate, keeping Presto at third base. Zaremba's 1-0 sits high. Ball 2 to Urban. Number 20, Christian Adams, has come out on deck. Would be pinch hitting for Joey Cicini. And the 2-0 from Zaremba in there. Hits him by the pitch. And the Ducks will have first and third now with one out. And Christian Adams coming up to the plate. We will have a mound visit before Christian Adams comes to the plate. Fourth hit by pitch of the game for the Ducks. Runners on first and third. Joey Urban at first. Dom Presto at third. Christian Adams pinch hitting for Joey Cicini. And out comes Zaremba. We have a pitching change here in the seventh. We'll be back right after this. Welcome back here to the bottom of the seventh. Ducks have two in already, and the bases, runners on first and third for Christian Adams, pinch hitting, and Josh Martos has come into the game. An update on the one other game going on around the SFCBL. The West Palm Beach Knights and the Boca Raton Blazers are tied at three in the top of the 10th. So in comes Josh Martos out of the University of Fort Lauderdale. One game, four innings pitched, four hits, one earned run, one walk, four Ks. Got the win in that one. Comes in with runners on first and third and one out. In the seventh, his first pitch fastball is high for ball one. So Adams pinch hitting here, his first at-bat on the day through seven games, batting 158, but a 407 on-base percentage, five walks, and three hit-by-pitches. Correction from the stat I mentioned earlier, the Ducks have five hit-by-pitches in this one. That's their total going into the day, 18, which led the league. Adams takes a strike on the outer half for strike number one, brings the count even to the new designated hitter. Makes 23 hit-by-pitches in 7-plus games. 8-plus games. Curveball in the dirt. Nice block by Goldfind behind the plate. 2-1 now the count to the left-handed Adams. Tying run at first base in Joey Urban. Go-ahead run at the plate here in the 7th. Christian Adams has a 2-1 count. Martos comes set. He'll check in over there at first with Urban. He's safe, diving back. Martos comes set at the belt. His 2-1 fastball sits high. Ball number three. Urban in the motion. Urban on the move. 3-1 pitch sits high, so Martos comes in and walks Christian Adams in his first at bat. And the bases are loaded for Jack Q. Bases loaded, one out for Jack Q. Singled in his last at bat in the 6th. Has reached base three times already in this one. Now up with one out. Tying run on second. Go-ahead run on first. Barracudas will play their corners in and their middle infielders back with one out in the 7th. First pitch curveball to Q. Q ducks for ball number one. Martos comes set. And the 1-0 to Q. Fastball elevated it. Got him to foul it off. Straight back. 1-1 now the count to the right fielder. One from Martos. Fastball at the knees, fouled off to the right side and out of play. 1-2 now the count on the right fielder Q. One out here in the 7th. Presto on third, at Urban on second, and Adams on first. Martos comes set. His 1-2 fastball lifted into the outfield. Back goes the center fielder Sweat. And he makes the catch for the second out. Presto will tag and score from third. Urban moves to second. And the Ducks have cut the lead to one. Now 7-6 in the 7th. So an RBI sacrifice fly there for Q. Urban moves to third. Adams stays at first. Now the first baseman, Cole Vida, 0 for 3 on the day. Tying run there at third base. Go ahead run still at first with one out in the bottom of the seventh. Martos' first pitch fastball in the dirt to Vida. Nice block by Max Goldfein. He has had a couple of them in the inning. Saves a run with the runner Urban at third. Martos comes set. Adams on the move. Vida grounds it. It takes a high bounce over the first baseman's shoulder. It goes into right field. Urban will score. Adams coming around third. He's held up late and will dive back into third safely. So an infield single from Vida scores Urban. Adams goes first to third because he was in motion. And the game is tied at 7. So the Ducks have gotten, the Ducks have gotten four back in the inning to tie this one up. Adams at third, Vida at first with two outs here in the bottom of the seventh. We'll have another mound visit by the Barracudas manager. Now up the second baseman, Dalton Frank, 0 for 3 on the day. Two flyouts and a ground out, looking to drive in what would be the leading run at third base. Vida on first with two outs, Adams on third. Martos' first pitch to Frank dots the outside corner for strike number one. Martos 0-1 fastball lifted into right. That will get down fair. Adams scores from third. Vida goes to first as DeNorcia gets it in. The Ducks have taken an 8-7 lead and dropped a 5 spot here in the bottom of the seventh. Now up the center fielder, Levi Padilla, 0 for 2 on the day, walked in the third. Runners on first and third, still with two outs in the seventh. Frank on the move. He'll steal the base as the shortstop, McLaughlin, cuts the ball off short. And now the Ducks have runners on second and third with two outs and Levi Padilla at the plate. First pitch was a strike there to Padilla, so he's 0-1. Martos on the mound, two outs in the bottom of the seventh. Martos is 0-1 to Padilla. Elevated fastball swung on and missed, and the center fielder is quickly down 0-2. Padilla resets, steps back into the plate. Martos comes set at the belt. And the 0-2 to Padilla, fastball fouled off. Count remains 0-2. The 0-2 once more to Padilla. Grounded up the middle. That gets past his second baseman, Platt. That will score two runs, and the Ducks take a 10-7 lead here in the seventh. Padilla got another fastball there and lined it right up the middle. Two RBI single for him. Ducks lead 10-7, and they have a seven spot here in the seventh. Ducks have batted around officially here. Williams led off the inning with a single. Came around to score the fourth run for the Ducks. Now the Ducks have 10 on the scoreboard. Williams back up here in the seventh with two outs. And now Padilla on first. Padilla in motion. Inside and hits William by the pitch. Another hit by pitch. Padilla was in motion, so he'll get second base still. The third of the inning and the sixth of the night for Barracuda pitchers. Cam Carroll will courtesy run for Williams at first once again. And now DJ Christian back up. Two singles in the third and the fifth. Reached on a fielder's choice error earlier in the seventh. Padilla's going to third. He will take third. They will throw behind and get Carroll at first, though. Padilla gets the stolen base, but Carroll is gunned down, throwing behind him at first. But the Ducks get seven in the inning and lead 10-7 as we are through eight. Through seven. Welcome back to the top of the eighth as the Ducks now have the lead 10-7. They dropped a seven spot in the bottom of the seventh. Steele Gately back out on the mound for the Ducks. Leading off for the Barracudas, the catcher Max Goldfein, 1-for-3 on the day, lined out to the shortstop in his last at bat. Got a little bit unlucky there. He leads it off for the Cudas in the eighth. Gately's first pitch fastball sits high for ball one. One oh slider in the dirt, 2-0 quickly to the catcher to lead off the top of the eighth. Two oh fastball in there for called strike number one. Gately back into the windup. And the 2-1 fastball in there on the outer half for strike number two brings the count back even to the catcher, 2-2 to lead off the inning. Gately's 2-2 fastball swung on and missed for strike three. Back-to-back strikeouts dating back to the seventh for Gately. One out now in the top of the eighth for the Barracudas. And up the extra hitter, Gabriel Rodriguez, a single in the fifth, hit by pitch in the sixth. So he's 1-for-2, reached base 2 out of 3 times. Now up, trying to reach base here with one out in the eighth. Gately's first pitch slider, absolutely filthy in the dirt, swung on and missed for strike number one. Goes to the curveball and gets that in there for strike number two. Quickly 0-2 to the extra hitter with one out in the top of the eighth. Gately back into the windup. 0-2 slider in the dirt. Williams tagged him. Two outs, back-to-back strikeouts. Three straight dating back to the seventh for Gately. And two outs for Joe DeNorcia, the right fielder. Gately looking much more efficient here in the eighth. Two straight strikeouts swinging for the first two outs. Now up the right fielder, Joe DeNorcia. He struck out in his first two at-bats himself. Now looking to get on with two outs in the eighth. Fastball swung on and missed on the inner half of the plate. 0-1 the count to the right fielder. Gately's 0-1 changeup sits away, brings the count back even to 1-1 on DeNorcia. Gately's 1-1 fastball blown right by DeNorcia. Upstairs, 1-2. Gately into the windup, goes back to the changeup on 1-2. That misses low, runs the count back even at 2-2. And the 2-2 fastball right by DeNorcia. Three strikeouts. He strikes out the side. And we are moving to the bottom of the eighth. Ducks up 10-7 on the Phipps Park Barracudas. Welcome back to the bottom of the eighth here at Joe Russo Field. Diamond Ducks lead 10-7 over the Phipps Park Barracudas. And leading off will be the left fielder, DJ Christian, as he was up when Cam Carroll was caught on the base paths, thrown behind by the catcher, Max Goldfein. So he comes back up with a clean count to lead off the bottom of the eighth. Josh Martos back out on the mound for the Barracudas. His first pitch fastball fouled off for strike number one. Martos' 0-1 fastball sits high, 1-1 now the count to the left fielder Christian, leading off in the bottom of the eighth for the Diamond Ducks. Dom Presto, the leadoff hitter on deck. O-1 fastball sits high, 2-1 now the count to Christian. Martos comes set. His 2-1 fastball sits high once again. 3-1 the count to lead off the bottom of the eighth. Three-one to Christian. Fastball on the outer half. In there. Runs a count full. 3-2 with nobody out here to lead off the bottom of the eighth. Christian chokes up, and the 3-2 inside hits him on the foot. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hit by pitches drawn by the Ducks in today's game, tacking on to their league-leading 18 entering the day. That's now 24, and we'll have another pitching change for the Barracudas, and we'll be back right after this as Dom Presto comes up with DJ Christian on first base. Now into pitch for the Phipps Park Barracudas, Justin Marlette out of Kaiser University. Two games pitched so far, two innings in that two games, one hit, one earned run, one walk, one K. Book is closed on Zaremba. 1 2/3 innings pitched for Zaremba, two hits, four earned runs, no walks, no hit strikeouts, but two hit by pitches. Book still open with DJ Christian at first base on Martos. Presto now at the plate as Marlette will check in on Christian at first. Presto on base three times today, two hit by pitches and a walk. Strikeout in the third. He lines that into right field. DeNorcia will come on and catch that for out number one here in the eighth.
Brad Hart now up for the Ducks. And Marlette gets the first pitch in there for call strike number one. Hart, an RBI ground out in the third, hit by a pitch in the fifth. Now up in the eighth with DJ Christian on first base and one out. His 0-1 fastball lifted foul quickly, 0-2 to the extra hitter. DJ Christian leads off first. Marlette's fastball in the outer half fouled back by Hart. Still 0-2.
Give him the spitball, Marty.
Christian in motion. The 0-2 changeup. 0-2 curveball on the outside corner for called strike three. Christian does take second base, though, and the Ducks have a runner in scoring position now with two outs in the bottom of the eighth with Joey Urban coming to the plate. Joey Urban hit by a pitch in the seventh, came around to score one of the Ducks' seven runs in that inning. Otherwise, he's 0-for-3, reached base on an error by the third baseman in the fifth. Now looking to drive Christian in with two outs in the eighth. Takes a change up low. That gets behind the catcher. Christian's going all the way home as he dives in. Marlette gets the tag in on Christian at home plate on the shirt as Christian tried to avoid the tag. So he gets a stolen base to third, but caught stealing trying to come home. And the Ducks lead 10-7 as we head to the ninth. Welcome back to the top of the ninth as the Palm Beach Diamond Ducks take a 3-run, 10-7 lead to the top of the ninth. Steele Gately back out on the mound. He is striking out four straight Barracudas. Struck out the side in the eighth, now back on for the ninth to face the top of the order. And Kyle Platt getting his fifth at bat, singled in the seventh. Hit by a pitch in the fifth. 1-for-3 on the day. Gately's first pitch fastball misses high for ball number one. Gately's 1-0 fastball lifted into center. Padilla settles under it and will put it away for out number one in the ninth. Now up the center fielder, Tanner Sweat. Single in the fourth, double in the fifth, walked in the seventh, looking to get things started in the top of the ninth with one out.
He swings and misses at a fastball in the dirt for strike number one. Gately's 0-1 fastball sits high, brings the count even to 1-1 on the center fielder. Gately into the windup. 1-1 fastball sits high, 2-1 now the count with one out here in the top of the ninth. Barracuda's facing a three-run deficit here, so they need base runners to get things started. 2-1 pitch from Gately sits high, 3-1 now the count. Gately into the windup. The 3-1 fastball sits high, and the Barracudas have a one-out walk for Kyle Machado coming to the plate. So the third baseman Machado now up, walked in the seventh, was hit by a pitch in the first, 0-2 on the day. Now up with a runner on first and one out in the ninth. Gately's first pitch hits Machado by the pitch in the knee, and the Barracudas have now two base runners on, tying run coming to the plate. So tying run at the plate, Chris Scholler now up. Singled in his last at-bat, a two RBI single of that in the seventh. He has runners on first and second and one out here in the ninth. First pitch to Scholler is up and in. That gets behind the catcher, Williams. Both runners will advance. Sweat to third. Machado to second on the wild pitch. 1-0 now the count. Steele Gately on the mound. Nobody up in the Ducks bullpen. It will be all his inning. Ducks will leave their infield back. Barracuda's got a clap going in anticipation for every pitch here in the ninth. A little bit of sportsmanship chirping going on. Gately into the windup. 1-0 slider misses. 2-0 now the count to Scholler. Gately's 2-0 fastball swung on, popped up on the infield. Frank drifts back into right field. The right fielder Q comes in, makes the catch. No tag at third by Sweat. And now one out here in the top of the ninth. Nice job by Jack Q coming in from right field to make the catch. No tag because it was shallow right by Sweat. And now Dylan Edwards at the plate. Edwards reached base once so far today. He takes the curveball in there for a called strike number one. Other than that, 0-3 on the day with two strikeouts. Gately into the windup. 1-1 curveball. Fair ball down the left field line. Christian chases it into the corner. Two runs will score for the Barracudas. As Edwards goes to second, he'll stay at second. And the tying run is at second for the Barracudas. Two RBI double there by Edwards into the corner. 10-9 now the score in the top of the ninth. Tying run at second base with just one out. And Colton McCautry at the plate. Two outs in the ninth. Two outs. So tying run at second with two outs. Fastball low, swung on and missed for strike one. That would have been ball one if he let it go. So two outs here with the runner on second. That's the tying run at second. 0-1 the count to McCautry. Fastball hits the inside corner, and the Barracudas are down to their final strike. 0-2 the count on the designated hitter. O-2 fastball just misses high for ball number one. Very close pitch at the top of the zone. 1-2 the count. Gately comes set. The 1-2 curveball inside blocked by Williams to keep the tying run. Edwards at second base. 2-2 now the count. Gately comes set. 2-2, fastball high. 3-2, now the count. 3-2, two out. The runner will not be in motion from a second because there's nobody in front of him and nobody behind him. But 3-2, the count, two outs. And Dylan McLaughlin, the shortstop, on deck. Tying run at second. Fastball misses high. Ball four, second walk of the inning. Now the go-ahead run is at first. Dylan McLaughlin, the shortstop, up. Two outs here in the top of the ninth. Pinch runner over there at first base for the go-ahead run. Gately comes set. His first pitch to McLaughlin just off the outer half for ball one. Runner for the Barracudas on first, Reese Woody. Fastball fouled off. Count runs even at 1-1 to the shortstop. McLaughlin, he has a single and a walk on the day, as well as a strikeout and a ground out to second. Tying run at second. Go-ahead run at first in the top of the ninth. 10-9, the Ducks lead. Gately comes set. And the 1-1 fastball just outside and low. 2-1 now the count to McLaughlin. Done. 10-1 rising here at Joe Russo Field. 2-1 the count. Gately comes set. And the 2-1. Just low and away. 3-1 now the count as McLaughlin is ahead. Edwards on second. The pinch runner Woody on first with the go-ahead run. Gately's 3-1 pitch, low, ball four, second straight walk. The bases are now loaded for the Barracudas. Tying run at third. Go-ahead run at second, and there will be a mound visit by Tino Godino, the manager for the Diamond Ducks, before that. Nobody up in the Ducks' bullpen, so it's all Steele Gately's inning. He came on to pitch in the seventh, so this is his third inning of work, and he's trying to get through it. Now with the tying run at third, go-ahead run at second, Edwards at third, Woody at second, and now McLaughlin at first here in the top of the ninth. Now up the catcher, Max Goldfein. 1-for-4 on the day, an RBI single back in the fifth. Big spot here in the top of the ninth. Steele Gately will go from the full windup with two outs. And his first pitch to Max Goldfein, ball high, 1-0 the count to Goldfein. 1-0 from Gately. Line foul. Broke the bat. 1-1 the count. So Goldfein gets a new bat. 1-1 the count here with two outs. Steel Gately still on the mound trying to find his way out of the ninth inning. Ducks lead 10-9. Barracudas have gotten two so far in the ninth. Tying run at third. Go-ahead run at second. Gately into the windup. 1-1 fastball sits high. 2-1 now the count. Two-one from Gately, swung on and missed. Goldfein loses the bat. It goes all the way into left field. Goldfein swung on and missed the outside fastball to make it 2-2. Lost the bat. It was his new bat after he broke his usual one earlier in the at bat rather. 2-2 now the count. Of note, Goldfein's first bat that he usually uses had some bat tape on it. The new one that he got had no bat tape on it. Now he's going to put some pine tar on to get some grip. 2-2, the count. The count with two outs. Tying run at third. Go-ahead run at second. Gately into the windup. 2-2 fastball swung on and missed. Strike three. And the Ducks hold on to win 10-9 here at Joe Russo Field. Bat slips out of Max Goldfein's hands once again. But the Ducks hold on to win 10-9 over the Phipps Park Barracudas. Gately bears down and the Ducks hold on to win once again. They move to 7-1 on the year. Four straight wins now as the Phipps Park Barracudas drop to 2-4. The Ducks are back in action with a doubleheader starting at 4 p.m. against the Delray Beach Lightning back here at Joe Russo Field. Coverage starts at 4. Two games tomorrow against the Delray Beach Lightning as they look for a fifth straight win tomorrow.